fucking break. Don't hear me screeching at you whenever you're twiddling your short and curlies.
Leaving, boy.
No, Fred. Well, you already soiled my solitude, so you may as well join me.
We're not hungry.
Good. It's not what I was offering.
Saw your brother again.
Congratulations. And I'm sure you'll let him go and Roger my axe good and plenty again, Let's see the damage. Little canker throat wouldn't know proper weight and balance if it were dangling off his chut. Is he eating well enough?
I guess.
Good. All better. Now what the fuck else you want, huh? Times he gets so wrapped up in his work, Sentry hasn't the sense to sip us up. And if he does remember, good luck getting him to cook his own meat. Guess I got all the stomach in the family. Along with the smarts.
You miss him.
What, that spit fister? What do you know?
I just mean
that... do you mind? Trying to concentrate here, already on a break from my break. And don't be letting that spit-fister of a brother of mine lay hands on it again. Well, what else were we talking about?
What is the path back to the witch? I see no tower.
Maybe I'm seeing things.
Do you remember the way back to the witch from here?
That way, behind the big statue of Thor. So, what happened when the horseman had dealt with the hunter?
He took the man's bit and bridle and allowed him to ride in the saddle on his back. Together, they killed the stag, and the horse tasted victory. But the hunter would not release the horse and made a slave of him.
So getting revenge cost him his freedom. Hope it was worth it.
It was not.
Nice shot.
Well?
Well, what?
The brazier?
If you must. Look here.
Kvekia.
See a scrap like that again.
Hey, this does more than decipher those Muspelheim runes. It also contains the travel rune. Should we go visit the fire rune?
Thank you, proper.
What do you want?
To thank you. These dead reavers drowned me many winters ago, and I've been itching to see them get theirs.
So you died after all the flooding?
Indeed. I came to the Lake of Nine to pillage Tyr's temple, but I underestimated the severity of the desolation.
Have you seen other men? Living? A bearded one with tattoos.
Only the one standing in front of me. Thank you both for avenging my death.
Useless.
Well, we can't expect them all to know something useful. Maybe the next one will have more information.
Keep your expectations low, boy. Spirits are rarely useful.
How do they even exist?
When you sever a man from his life, it is not always a clean cut.
So you've met other spirits?
Yes. Many.
What were they like?
Annoying.
Got another story?
One more. There was a tale of a frog. His pond had dried up, so the frog and his son left to find a new home. They found a well. The son saw the water and made to jump in, but the father stopped him. He saw the well was deep, and once inside, they would not be able to escape if the water dried up again. Wisely, they moved on.
That's it?
Yes.
It's really not a story. If the son jumped in, it would be a story.
Then he would be trapped and starve while the father watched helplessly.
See? That's a story. Got another story?
Very well. There was a young man who was caught stealing and condemned to die. His mother came to visit his prison. She was a kind woman who could only give love. But her son, the thief, met her with rage and bit off her ear.
What? Why?
Because the boy had always been a thief, and his mother had taught him only love and nothing of consequences. Had he been taught discipline instead, he might have lived longer.
Sure, but her ear, that's not right.
Thank you.
There's something up there.
Want to try another story? It can't be any worse than the last one.
Very well. There was the story of the mother crab, who scolded her son. She told him he should walk forward, in pride, not sideways as he always did.
But she's a crab too. He should say, sure, I'll walk forward as soon as you show me how.
Yes, he did say that. That was the story.
I got it.
Yeah!
something we can use here. Let's come back. Got another story?
Very well. There's a tale about a woodsman. He asked the trees of the forest for a branch to make a handle for his axe. Instead, the trees gave him a young sapling so they could keep their limbs. But set that aside, we must proceed on foot.
Can we finish later?
Perhaps.
This needs a different cipher than the one we have. These are the ones I can't read.
Let's do it. Sure, that's a load off your mind.
Oh, guess we're not going back to the woods just yet. I can read what this says now, but
It's a name.
Rota! Whoa! The name made it light up.
It is not a name I know.
Me neither. Huh.
I still can't read these. Oh. I can read these now.
It says Muspahan. The Fire Realm is the gauntlet of the Sorcerer. Like a magic glove?
Or a series of dangers.
We should go see sometime.
I still can't read these.
Atreus, to me!
I'm coming!
Something we can use here. Let's come back. This may need something we don't have.
Jump!
And empty, this place is still creepy. We'll need something to get through this one.
Clear!
Destroyed.
Even if we could take the cargo, the next platform broke when we fought the dragon. Did you already forget?
Dead.
I was gonna say ancient, but dead works too.
Look here.
Okay. That's going in the journal.
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe a whetstone? I'm feeling less cluttered already.
Read it.
Sir.
Father!
story were you going to tell?
There is a tale about a woodsman. He asked the trees of the forest for a branch to make a handle for his axe. Instead, the trees gave him a young sapling so they could keep their limbs. The woodsman made his axe, and then he returned and chopped down the oldest trees in the forest.
Just because trees are old doesn't mean they're smart.
His grave lies on an island to the east.
Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor for the monstrous eyesore.
I cannot rest while my mother's murderer stands above my father's grave.
Yeah.
My father was buried with a valuable family heirloom. It is yours. My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor with that monstrous eyesore to the south.
Some loot up there. How about one more story?
Very well. There was once a scorpion who wished to travel to the other side of a river.
Why?
If you continue to interrupt, I will end the story.
Okay.
The scorpion asked the frog for help. He told the frog that if he gave him a ride across the river on his back, he would be rewarded. The frog protested, fearing the scorpion would sting him. The scorpion assured the frog that he would not sting him, or they would both drown in the river. The frog agreed, but halfway across the river, the scorpion stung him. The frog was mortally wounded, and they both sunk to the bottom of the river and perished. But set that aside. We must proceed on foot.
Can we finish later?
Perhaps. Boy, over here.
Sir. Vaithargar. Southern outposts of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
Hey, Brock. You ever hear of a Dwarf King?
I suppose you're talking about Motsignir? Some bitch ruled over the humans once lived in this area. Built itself a castle just north of here.
A dwarven castle? What's it like?
You got yourself a pair of eyes and legs, ain't you? Might want to stock up before you head that way, though. Old Molsignir's known for collecting all manner of killer creatures. Not sure who's looking after him now. Whatever helps, right? Yeah, check back soon.
So the scorpion really stung the frog?
Yes.
That's sad. Why would the scorpion do that?
He was a scorpion. It is his nature to do harm.
Oh. That's just what Mom used to say about the gods.
Your mother always spoke the truth. Enough stories.
Hey, that looks like a water wheel. Or I guess, an underwater wheel. Did you just laugh at that?
No.
You sure?
Yes. I do not laugh.
Don't I know it.
Boy. Atreus, follow me.
All right, what'd you break? Now, about that other thing.
Where's your beast of burden?
What do you mean? I ate her. Fat bits of her out just a while ago.
What is wrong with you?
What? Her milk ran dry.
She was your friend.
And she'll be happy I'm so well fed. Shit bricks, boy, you got a real cinnamon streak, know that? Don't get yourself confused, Al.
Come.
Right behind you.
Come, boy. Roy, do you remember which is port and which is starboard?
Oh, I think so. Port is left, and starboard is right. Right?
Not your right. Where the boat faces, port is left, and starboard,
starboard is right. Right. I knew that. I did. I bet this will lead out. Turn back Aesir. Guess the gods aren't welcome here. There he is! I hope he remembers us. This is good to know. I bet this will lead out.
Father, this looks interesting.
Here. Boy.
Another map. Bet we'll find something useful here. This is locked up good. Another one of those bowls of sand up there. Can I drill the engine to? Not sure how we reach it. Robert, look up there. I see something up there.
Bet I could reach that with some help.
Jump over with those wooden boards in the way. It is. It's another one of those sand bowls. There are different runes written along the side of this one.
What does it say?
Another riddle. Feed me not, we both are doomed. Overfeed me, all consumed.
The answer might be near, like the other.
The answer's gotta be written around here somewhere, right? I see it now. It says fire. Of course. Bow.
Atreus, follow me. Betray us to me.
I'll scout ahead. How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. Or what it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie. Another one of those sandals. Want me to read this one?
What does it say?
Yes, sir. Death to the Raven God. Lord of the Hand.
Read it.
Yes, sir. Save their knee themes upon all who trespass. Thank you.
to be a better tool for this job.
Here, boy.
Go!
I know those runes. That's Vinder. Wind. Must be for that sand bowl down there.
Thank you.
Atreus, to me.
What does it say?
Falcon, hawk, and turtle dove. Swim aloft in oceans above. Ah, wind. Wind.
Look what it did!
She is here. It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. What's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Hamelin! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well, thankfully his head hasn't decayed much and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it.
Thank you.
That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir, you there?
Yes.
Good.
Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the witch in the woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either. Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are God.
Leader of the Vanir once, yes, but no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
But...
now.
You're welcome.
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Or have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied. Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother. When I require your counsel, head, I will ask.
Fair enough.
Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Who better to tell us the way?
The world serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed.
He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
It's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.